Hello and welcome to Coastal Now. I'm Robin Russell. CCU's brand new baseball stadium is really taking shape. Head baseball coach Gary Gilmore has looked forward to the day when his Chanticleer student athletes would step onto that field. We had the chance to get an exclusive tour of the nearly completed facility, conducted by Gilly himself. And what's the timeline of all these completions?
We're hoping they can push the elements here and get this thing done, because we've got, we have the most difficult and comprehensive schedule we've ever played. We have Clemson coming here, we have South Carolina coming here, North Carolina's coming here, Wake Forest, Michigan, Michigan State. That's what I keep telling them. I gotta get the team ready, they gotta get this thing done.
Your office.
Yeah, we've come a long way since the old trailer.
This is as large as the old trailer,
exactly.
Isn't it?
No doubt.
And why did you pick this spot, Gilly?
Well, it gives me, that's what I tell the guy, tell the players, that I know every guy that's on the field, and I know every guy that walks in that hitting facility out there,
that.
So they can't ever cheat me out of saying that they were there when I know they weren't. So, but this is really nice. I mean, it's very, very, very classy place to bring a young man and sell your program
to him. Right, absolutely. Gary, how long have you been waiting on a locker room like this?
All my life. This is a dream come true, Robin. Yeah, I mean, it's one of the best places in the country. This selfless and relentless are two key words that our program, we want our players to stand for, and this will kind of be cordoned off. The only way you get to be in here is, after a game we win and the player of the game gets to be in the center with me, and that's the only time they can ever walk in here. The best part about all this, Robin, is when the kids walk through that door, the sense of pride that honestly has been struggling,
It's breathtaking.
It's for
and
people
having you deserve having that sense of pride,
Oh, well, I appreciate that. I mean, we're going to work hard and we're going to get it done.
Gary, this is pretty much a game changer. I mean, we talked about from a recruitment standpoint. How else is this a game changer? I mean,
the whole design, the whole idea behind this park, not only to help recruit, but for you to bring your family, for your kids to be able to sit in a seat for a while and go, hey, Mom, I want to fly around this place and burn off some energy, but you don't have to leave the ballpark to do it. It should be one of the more fan-friendly ballparks in the whole country in any college situation ever. I mean, it really is. It's not many places the only place you don't see the ball game is from the restroom. That's it. Everywhere else you go in this ballpark, you can eat, you can do anything you want to here, and you'll see the baseball game.
I want to know what it's going to feel like that first day when you're standing out there.
My dad was so much part of my life, and he passed away, last March, and I know that thought will go through my mind, that of all things, I know how much he wanted to be here, and I know how much I wanted him to be here. I'll miss him not being able to share that moment with me, but, for most part, this is about a whole lot of men that have put time and effort into this since the day baseball first started here. It's not about me, it's not about this team, it's about 25, 30 years of people sweating and toiling on the same playing surface. Yeah. That part hasn't changed. It's the same, the same coastal playing surface that guys played on 25, 30 years ago is right out there. And, we want to take it and, we want to do a dog pile out there that sends us to Omaha.
Another individual who has nurtured the development of this world-class baseball-softball complex is CCU Interim Director of Athletics, Matt Hoag. And Matt, this is clearly more than just a facility for playing ball. There's a much larger picture here. Talk about that.
Well, it's a showpiece, and in the world of intercollegiate athletics, if you don't have the resources that can attract the best players, the best recruits, then you're going to struggle to succeed. We have the fortune that we have a great program under Coach Gilmore that he's built throughout the years. Now we add in the final puzzle piece of having a facility that is commensurate with that program that he's built. So our expectation is that we're really going to be able to get out there and find the kind of players that can get us to Omaha.
How long has this been talked about?
Well, I think you probably go back well over a decade once the program started to come into prominence in the early 2000s that we needed a facility that would be equal to what the abilities and the success on the field were. But as you know, it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort and a lot of different processes to go through to get to this point, not to mention the fact, the least of which is finding the funds to pay for it. And finally, all of those pieces came together and we were able to build what is really going to be one of the best stadiums in all of college baseball. When you compare this, and believe me, I've been a lot of places, I've seen what folks have. This will be the envy of SEC schools. This will be the envy of ACC schools. We have vaulted into probably the top 15 or 20 in the country in terms of overall facilities.
And we think it'll be ready to go on the first game?
We're playing baseball on February 13th. There'll definitely be some construction going on with the final phase, the berm and boardwalks that will be installed. But we'll be playing baseball when the season starts.
How exciting. We've been waiting for this a long time, Matt. I'll see you at that first game.
Ready to go.
Coming up on Coastal Now, see how the elves of CCU came together for a major production, complete with a few holiday celebrities. And there's a very important question we're pondering on the pond. What is your favorite holiday movie?
My favorite holiday movie would probably have to be The Ultimate Christmas Present from Disney Channel.
Probably The Grinch, because, you know, he starts out hating Christmas and all that, and then by the end he loves Christmas.
Santa Claus is Coming to Town, the old one from the 60s. I grew up watching that with my parents. There's something to be said about the classics.
My favorite holiday movie definitely has to be National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, because it is frankly hilarious.
My favorite is Elf, because the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Resource item. Please make 3 selections. Person, attention. Location and planning. Affordability. Exploring what CCU has to offer. Please make 2 selections. Experiential learning. Community. Exploring what CCU has to offer. Engage in these selections at coastal.edu.
We're back. One of the highest honors that CCU presents is the Founders Medallion. The university recognizes honorary founders for the instrumental role that they have played in the development of CCU. In this story, we learn how honorary founder Joe Barry worked tenaciously to help the university gain independence.
When it came time for USC Coastal Carolina College to become Coastal Carolina University, a committee for independence was set up. Craig Walsh Sr. had imparted to his son and others that this institution would never reach its full potential unless it was independent and had its own board of trustees.
So once the big decision was made to do it, I don't think any of us had thought about how do you do it.
Cathcart Smith had been involved in higher education in South Carolina through the State Commission on Higher Education. And Craig Wall and Jimmy Johnson, they really got behind this and were driving forces.
Obviously, this had to be done in the state legislature. They were controlling whether it happened or not. Legislature in South Carolina sort of controls everything.
Mr. Wall had a plan, and Jimmy had a plan of action. Part of that plan involved having the right person in Columbia representing us throughout the process, and that right person was Joe Barry.
He was the point man for us. We didn't know how to do this thing. We didn't know how to work the legislature to get it done. We certainly had the support of our Horry County legislative delegation, but we needed somebody that could guide this process through the legislature. And Joe was the right man, and he did it.
Joe was longtime chair at the College of Charleston and a longtime lobbyist in Columbia, and was well respected both places in the higher education circles in South Carolina and by the General Assembly.
The bill was introduced into the legislature in 1993 in the Senate, sponsored by most of the senators from around here all the way down to Charleston, and it was sent to the Senate Education Committee, and it sat there for a while.
One senator put his name on as objecting to the bill. It was dead. That happened, and there was an effort to advance a issue and a bill that happened to benefit that particular senator's constituency. And so there was a suggestion that we put an objection on his bill. And as soon as we did that, the effort to get Coastal Carolina University that status and become independent passed, because that senator removed his name from our bill.
Joe was sort of a quiet operator, but he knew who to touch and when to touch, and that's what he brought to it.
His job was to make sure the General Assembly knew the reasons that Coastal Carolina wanted to be independent, and to make sure that they knew that they were good reasons.
We could have been Coastal Carolina College, but in a discussion I recall with Joe in his office, he asked me, he said, well, are you a college or a university? I said, well, today we're a college, but we're going to be a university. And he said, well, let's build for the future, and let's make sure the term university is in this legislation, and so we won't have to come back later and change it and go through the political process again. And there was never a question about it.
It was made very easy because of the dedication that these Horry County people had.
Frankly, a lot of it was through connections. And when he would come to us, it was sort of a done deal. He'd already had it lined up.
Since 1977, and I spent many a day in the lobby and in the halls and the House and the Senate, you know, getting to know people and getting people to know me. As long as you are a straight shooter with the members of the legislature, they will listen to you and respect you for it.
Another thing that Joe Barry needed to do was to make sure that the key leaders of the Board of Trustees at the University of South Carolina, who needed to be on board with this, were informed and given the reasoning and explained to them and educate them why we wanted to be independent.
I recommend to our Board of Trustees that we pursue the independence in both name and administration of our campuses at Aiken, Coastal, and Spartanburg. These events should proceed with sensitivity, care, and purpose.
There was great fear, I think, of what Coastal would become, and particularly some within the sister campuses of South Carolina's university system.
And there were some people were concerned about it, protecting their own turf.
Joe Barry was central and crucial to us gaining independence from the University of South Carolina and as a freestanding institution.
Because he is truly a founder of this institution. Honorary or actual, he is part of the history of this institution.
It's mighty nice that they would consider giving me that honor. It really is. I'm truly humble.
We were very fortunate for two things. First of all, that Craig Wall Jr. had a vision, along with his father, of independence for Coastal Carolina University, and a great plan to get there. And also that there were individuals like Joe Barry outside of Horry County that could help us get there.
The holidays can be incredibly fun, especially when we come together to help others. That was the spirit of this year's CCU Holiday Video Card, as we captured in this behind-the-scenes montage.
We're actually signing the holiday card. It's going to be captured in a video, and we actually have a lot of different activity stations. We have a photo booth, Christmas cookie decorating, as well as sending letters to soldiers.
Also this year, our colleges are manning these volunteer tables with all the great activities. We really appreciate the huge effort that's come out from across the university community.
This is the table for people who would like to write a note to our service members who are serving overseas and will be overseas during Christmas. When you're done, they go in the box, and the Gold Star mothers will send them with their Christmas packages to soldiers who are serving overseas.
We've got all these activities going on at various different stations, but one specifically is what we've got going on here with the setting the table for the fall. So each of the offices, departments, individuals who are providing a meal for a family, they're bringing their stuff out here on Prince Lawn, they're signing the card, they're participating in the events, but they're also really impacting Conway, Horry County, the Grand Strand in a way that exceeds the campus boundaries.
I think this is a phenomenal turnout. From what we're seeing, there's a lot of excitement out here on the Prince Lawn, and that's what this is all about in the holiday season, is the excitement that you see on this campus.
It's just special to bring everyone from all walks of the campus life together to join in the spirit of the holiday season, to bring joy, and everybody just looking around and watching people laugh and have a good time is just an awesome thing to see on this campus.
When we come back, you'll see the premiere showing of CCU's holiday video greeting card. And you'll meet a soccer athlete whose biggest competitor on the field is actually her sister.
Here at Coastal Carolina University, we're not just building dreams, we're building the future. With real hands-on experiences and a personal touch, we prepare you for the real world and real success. Connect to your future and discover what Coastal can offer you.
Welcome back. Without question, fall 2014 goes down in history as a very exciting season for many of our student athletic programs. In women's soccer, the competitive nature of forward Kacey Kelley extends beyond her opponents on the field to her own sibling who plays alongside her.
Kacey Kelley, 21, senior, Ashburn, Virginia. I always knew when I was younger that I wanted to be involved in sports. Even my mom has told me I always knew you were an athlete from a very young age. And I got involved in soccer around 4 or 5 and just continued my career through there. I was involved in a couple of those sports because my mom was a swimming coach, so I swam my whole life as well as played soccer. She definitely has impacted me a lot through athletics because she's always encouraged me to continue my career. She's been behind me 100%. Given me the opportunities that I have today to be here at Coastal. I was actually never recruited by Paul because all the changes were happening, and I actually wasn't sure if I was gonna come here or not, but Paul came to my house for dinner one night and he's reassured me that he's gonna bring this program to a new level, challenge us every day, work hard, and I think he's done a great job with this program and will continue to do so. I have a very competitive mindset. I do not like to lose. So I'm always looking for goals to be scored, helping our team get that win all the time. And I just love being out there with all the girls. My whole life, I actually was a defender. And my sophomore year is my first year that I actually played forward. It was around a spring of my freshman year when they noticed I could just was scoring goals nonstop during training sessions, and they tried me one day, like, wow, we never knew she could score goals. So then it's kind of how I got involved in the attack. I've never worn the number 21 before. This is my first time ever wearing it. My dad's favorite number is 7, and it was not available, so I chose 21 just because it kind of relates to 7 in a way. So I wanted to have a part of him on the field with me. My sister is my biggest competitor as well as my biggest cheerleader on the field. You know, I can always count on her to pick me up, or going against someone that will challenge me nonstop, because I know she'll give me a fight no matter what. It's kind of cool having you here at school with me, because you know, not many people get the chance to go to school with their siblings and have like such a great career and soccer career with them. So it's pretty cool to have her here by my side the whole time.
The holidays are a special time to celebrate traditions. At CCU, one day is set aside to help others get into the spirit of the season. It's kind of become our own tradition. Here's our holiday greeting to you.
3, 2, 1. Yeah!
Happy holidays.
Merry Christmas.
From the Office of University Council.
C-I-N-O, C-N-O.
Have a teal trailblazing Christmas.
Have a cheer-tastic holiday.
Shots and deer wish you good cheer.
I want to wish
what
you a
said.
Merry Christmas.
Giving deals good.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Happy career.
Happy holidays from the Wall College of Business.
Merry Christmas from Kimball Library.
Wishing you success in the new year.
And Merry Christmas.
Wishing you joy this season and happiness throughout the year.
Happy holidays from the School of Coastal and Marine Systems Science.
From our teal nation to yours,
have a healthy holiday.
Merry Christmas from the Office of Admissions.
Merry Lexmas.
Remember to stay active this holiday season.
Someone tell Santa we want waves for Christmas down here at Coastal Carolina. Happy holidays.
College of Education.
Create your own spin on the world.
Become a teacher.
Hey Santa, call me mister.
We hope your holiday isn't as lovely as our sweaters.
С Новым годом и Рождеством!
C-I-N-O, ho, ho, ho!
May your baskets be full of cheer.
Merry Christmas!
Lully Yul!
Merry Christmas!
From our family to yours,
Happy Holidays!
Please make three selections. Person, attention. Location and climate. Affordability. Exploring what CCU has to offer. Please make two selections. Experiential learning. Community. Exploring what CCU has to offer. Engage in these selections at coastal.edu.
Season's greetings, Teal Nation, and welcome back to the Social Circle. Any business, organization, or university that has a strong social media program will do all they can to connect with their audiences on major holidays. Many companies find that the most effective and spirited way to do this is through a custom-made graphic. Here at Coastal Carolina University, we agree. When a holiday comes around, you can definitely expect a Chanticleer-themed greeting to pop up on your Facebook or Instagram feed. We believe that the more creative, the better. Let's go back in time real fast. On the 4th of July, we paid tribute to one of our nation's most recognizable images by introducing our Uncle Chauncey graphic. Inspired by the Uncle Sam, I Want You poster, we achieved our goal of a patriotic and unique greeting. On Halloween, we got a little spooky. By taking the image of a rooster, we mixed in the holiday colors of black and orange with the perfect touch of teal. The shot moon in the background set the scene perfectly. Then, just recently for Thanksgiving, we rolled out our CCU pumpkin pie image. Love or hate this popular dessert, you have to admit that you want a slice of that. So, where did these strokes of creative brilliance come from? Well, you can stop looking at me. I am fortunate enough to utilize the graphics team here at CCU to really bring the holidays to the smart devices and computers of our social media audience. About a week before a big date on the calendar approaches, I meet with Director of Creative Services, Rob Wyatt, to discuss the upcoming graphic. Sometimes I give him suggestions on what I would like to see, and other times I just say run with it. Rob will then either distribute the job to one of his team members or take on the project himself. They work their magic and then present me with a beautiful graphic that is ready to make your holiday brighter. Let me ask you this, are you ready for the Christmas graphic? Although I'm keeping quiet on what it will look like, I can say that I'm pretty sure you'll want to like, share, and retweet it. Stay tuned. Happy holidays to you, Robin.
Thank you, Brent. And we leave you with the festive scenes from the annual CCU Holiday Tree Lighting, held in the heart of campus on Blanton Park. Season's greetings to you all, and best wishes for a wonderful new year.